The numbers are quite alarming. More than $100 billion worth of debt and a $16 billion deficit. But the New South Wales Treasurer insists the way to recovery and prosperity is through borrowing, building and tax cuts. Dominic Perrottet also used today's budget to flag sweeping changes to one of our most despised taxes, stamp duty.
A budget like no other in a year already written into history.
Exactly 1 year ago to the day, the first known case of what we now know to be COVID-19 was detected in central China.
COVID forcing Dominic Perrottet's books into the red, handing down a whopping $16 billion deficit for this financial year.
This is 100% the right budget for the times.
A combination of plunging revenue and a mega $53 billion of debt, that number will balloon to $104 billion in 3 years' time. Borrowing big while money's cheap and the state is on the rebound from economic disaster.
When the pandemic broke, we made a conscious decision to put the economy before the budget.
Ploughing $29 billion into the health and economic response to COVID, the disease cost lives and shutdowns at their height cost the economy $1.4 billion a week. Even now, with relatively free movement, restrictions are still costing $400 million every week. Today, a helping hand for small businesses in the form of $1,500 grants. Money, too, to clear the lengthy elective surgery backlog created by a pause in operations and a whopping $107 billion for infrastructure, including for two metro lines, one to Parramatta and the other servicing the new Badgerys Creek Airport and the Gateway Road Link. But no money for Parramatta Light Rail Stage 2, a building boom creating 145,000 jobs a year over the next 4 years that are desperately needed.
Between March and May, almost 270,000 New South Wales workers lost their jobs.
While COVID-19 has ravaged the budget, it's also presented an opportunity for the Treasurer, who's pushing go on a tax reform agenda he's been championing for years.
Cutting the payroll tax rate from 5.45 to 4.85 for 2 years, a windfall of $2.4 billion for business owners, and permanently lifting the threshold.
It's a win that we can bring on some more staff. It may be a saving for up to $20,000, $30,000 a year for some businesses.
We'll of course be campaigning for the next couple of years about how important it is to keep that payroll tax rate as low as possible.
Reform, the opposition says, doesn't go far enough.
He's tinkered around the edges. He's touched the threshold and he's touched the rate. Where is the bravery and the reformist agenda to actually get people back into work?
After leading one of the most successful health responses in the world, the Premier hailing her Treasurer for his fiscal recovery plan.
We have the best Treasurer in the world delivering to the people of New South Wales.
Liz Daniels, Nine News.